I'm glad that we can talk about the show now that I've seen a few episodes. My one complaint is that I've seen the first four and I need 5 through 8 right now. So please make that happen.
We'll get right on that. 100%.
Thank you. I need to watch that soon. So listen, I got a ton of questions about Fallout, but I want to ask one other question first, which is, do you think I'm ever going to get a 4K box set of Westworld?
Ooh, we will make it happen. We'll make it happen. I'm trying to remember the last configuration. We put a lot of love into those box sets. We sort of aware of the fact that it's a dying art form, right? And an important one. So there's a lot of love that went into them. We'll get you something special.
Yeah, I mean, listen, I like physical media. Yeah. And I think that's a show that would be a really cool 4K box set.
100%. And I think, we were one of the first shows that did a 4K UHD transfer for season one. There's a lot of love that went into making that show. And I think physical media is, you knew as soon as Best Buy pulled it out of their stores that it's poised for a comeback.
Listen, we're on the exact same page. So jumping into Fallout, you've directed, I want to say, 4 episodes of TV before Fallout. Could be wrong, but I think
right.
That's the number.
Yeah.
So what was it about Fallout that said, I want to like helm 3 episodes and, be in the driver's seat?
Yeah, I think the challenge from this from the beginning, well, it was also the fun, was the world building, right? The tone of the games is unique, but the scope and ambition of the games was one of the things that led us to want to do this project in the first place. And so to be able to try to translate that scope, these are games where you can walk in almost any direction, over any horizon, pick up almost any object and look at it. I mean, the scope of the games is breathtaking and ambitious. It's part of what it's there with all the games. It's also part of what Todd Howard does and everything that he works on. There's these massive, massive environments. So I think it's a challenge, as a throwing down the gauntlet in terms of saying, well, how do we try to capture that? For me, as a director, world building is the whole game. It's why I wanted to do the pilot for Westworld. I wanted to figure out how we would bring that world to life, a unique visual tone. And here the challenge was adaptation, where you knew what some of these things would look like, but you'd figure out how on earth you're gonna make that a reality for the cast, but then also for the audience. And the answer was in many ways the same. As you pack up your carry-on and you get on a plane and you fly somewhere amazing. And you figure it out.
So one of the main complaint for me about streaming shows is that there's normally a very large gap between seasons.
Sure.
And I wanted to know, what have you guys done, if you're lucky enough to make a season two, like to get ready? So if Prime Video says, hey, we want another one, like, have you worked on scripts? Do you know what season two is about? Like, how can you make that gap sooner?
Yeah, no, I find that gap frustrating as well. Part of it is just the ambition of these shows, right? The from Game of Thrones and shows like Game of Thrones and then Westworld onwards, that practical photography means it takes time. But I am as frustrated as anyone that it takes this long to get these shows on the air. So we are. We are poised and hopeful that we weren't not going to have to wait quite that long, should we be so lucky.
Well, one of the things about the first season of a show is you're building the infrastructure.
Yeah.
How long does it take to make an episode? What does it really cost to do these visual effects? Like, all that stuff has to be figured out. So what did you learn making the first season that will, maybe help you making the second season in terms of, I mean, whatever it is, if you, hopefully that makes sense.
Yeah. I mean, it's not unlike, and I've made this analogy before, it's not unlike when I was working with my brother, watching him have to build all the elements of that Batman universe, right? The first movie, you have to make the car, the suit, the cave, the house. You have to figure all these things out. And it's an extra 6 months of prep, really. Just an extraordinary amount, but you do have a lot of that you carry with you. And one of the reasons why I wanted us to make The Dark Knight was not only because I'd written the script and I was pretty excited about it, but because my point to my brother was, it's like we built this sports car and you had a chance to get in it and take it for a ride. So with your second season, you do come to it. Now, the challenges for us with Fallout were the scope of the environments, figuring out how to make that work. Also the creature creation, the practical and vis effects based, you know, creature creation, which was more than not entirely new to us, but more than I had done before. And by the end of the first season, we had figured out an awful lot of the tools that we use to make this universe. So you do get some economies of scale going into it, but then in any second chapter, you'd want to make it that much more ambitious. So you have a lot of stuff that you start with, but then you have a lot. And this is part of it for us with Westworld, was wanting to constantly one-up ourselves every season. Like, okay, we built the park. Now, how do we build the outside world? And the challenges of that, you know, directorially was so much of the fun of that and of this is you want to keep topping yourself.
If in a dream world, you're allowed to make whatever amount of seasons of Fallout that you want to make, are you thinking this is like a 4-year show, a 6-season show, like, or have you not thought that far ahead?
No, we talk about it. It's really more of a question for Graham and Geneva and how excited they are. I think with television, one of the beauties of it is if the audience comes out for it, if people are excited to see it, there's an invitation to keep going. But I think one of the lessons that I learned very early on in filmmaking, again, on those Batman movies, was it's nice if you get a chance to go again, but you got to put everything you can into the season that's in front of you.
I'm fascinated by the editing process because it's where it all comes together. Mm. So how did your episodes possibly change in the editing room in ways you didn't expect, or was it exactly how you envisioned it?
No, I think editing on anything, especially the first episode or the first season of a new show, you'd be foolish going into it thinking that you had nailed everything on the page. Geneva and Graham are terrific writers, and the scripts were beautiful from the beginning. I think from the beginning it was very clear that they had nailed the tone for me, the unique, weird, wild tone of the games. But you understand that there's a certain amount of pieces moving around, especially with an ensemble, especially where you're trying to, in order to do justice to the fact that in the games your character can be good, bad, or somewhere in between. Geneva and Graham quite early in the process landed on this idea of a three-hander, that with Ella, Aaron, and Walton's characters, you got to lay out that moral spectrum in one go. When you're doing ensemble and omnibus ensemble storytelling, and we learned this the hard way on Westworld, that pilot took months to cut together. And there was an awful lot of the pilot in Westworld that pieces got picked up and moved around and turned into subsequent episodes. Some of the stuff that I was proudest of that we'd shot for the pilot wound up becoming. So you kind of understood going into it that you got to be a little loose. You've got to be a little open to it. Ironically, we wound up in a place with this series where the first couple episodes really took us back to where we started with Geneva and Graham's early scripts in terms of getting a little bit of a sense for all of these characters. And that really was the challenge. You can't just come to know Ella's character. You've got to get to know Aaron's character, and you've got to get to know Walton's character. So first season shows are always a delicious challenge. And this one was challenging, but we're very satisfied with the results.
If you get to make a season 2, will you be directing 3 episodes again? Have you not even thought that far ahead?
haven't thought that far ahead. Just looking at the show in front of us, what I will say is that working with this cast, this terrifically talented cast and this incredible crew, was an absolute pleasure.
Yeah, you also did a great job with these episodes, which is why I'm asking if you're going to do more.
Thank you. I appreciate that.
I definitely have to ask you, are you thinking about directing a feature at any point?
Oh, I love movies. I mean, I think I've been lucky in my career to work in both. I started in the film business. I'm just having a lot of fun right now in the television business and having fun with what's right in front of me. But I do love the movies. So we'll see.
I have to stop there. I'm just going to say, listen, congrats on the show.
Thank you.
I would be really, really shocked if it doesn't get a second season.
Oh, I appreciate that. Thank you so much. Thank you for the kind words.